Welcome to this Web Extra segment of On the Clock. Now, time for some rapid-fire debate. On our line, panelists have just 1 minute as a group to discuss each of this week's topics. So, first one, once again, scathing remarks published in Rolling Stone make headlines, this time leading President Obama to accept General Stanley McChrystal's resignation and appoint General David Petraeus to his post as top commander in Afghanistan. Let's see. Jim, was he right to do it, meaning resign or be fired? And will this change anything with Petraeus versus McChrystal?
Was he right to do what?
McChrystal resigning. Was he right to do that after what he did in Rolling Stone in that interview?
I thought he was replaced.
Yeah.
That's why I was surprised.
Yeah. Sorry about
no,
that.
Listen.
Allowed to resign.
Lincoln,
right.
Lincoln McClellan, yeah. Franklin Roosevelt, Douglas C. MacArthur, yep. Obama, McChrystal. The civilian authority has to retain the upper hand. Mm-hmm. They serve the president, right or wrong, and if he has disagreements with what's going on, you don't roll them out in the Rolling Stone.
Right.
Lady Gaga.
Right. Totally. One of the things that really struck me about that was like, I'm sorry, Rolling Stone doesn't come out the next day.
Right.
He and his staff knew for like 2 months. I mean, that's maybe an exaggeration, but they knew for a while.
That's a
at
very
least they
good
called
point.
Before it was published.
Well, yeah, exactly.
I was just going to say, I'm from a military family. My husband and I talked about it, former Marine. This is no surprise. It's a surprise that he said it, but it's no surprise that he submitted his resignation and the president accepted it. The Uniform Military Code of Justice says that this is actually punishable by court-martial. Mm-hmm. You know, questioning.
Interesting point. I forgot about that. Yeah, 10 seconds, if you could.
Well, the irony for me is that he criticized the president for being weak, and I think that he was summarily dismissed with exacting precision. Mm-hmm. And I think it's ironic to me that he criticized him and then he came back as quickly as he did and just made a final decision. I think it was the right one.
Sure, mm-hmm. We'll see how it plays out militarily, as they say. Now, Newsweek's report on America's top high schools includes 3 in New Mexico, an honor given only to 6% of the nation's high schools. And this is an indication that the education initiatives implemented by Governor Richardson and Education Secretary Veronica Garcia, are they reaping fruit? Let me start with you, Stephanie. Please rescue me from my misuse of that.
How do you follow him?
That's right.
That was great. I think this is great news. I think this is good. But I am always skeptical with anything that includes standardized testing. Yeah. So I will say good news, skeptical about the formula that got us there. But still, great news.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't think you can credit it to Bill Richardson and Veronica Garcia, because Hobbs School ranked the highest, and they have their own special program down there in Eddy County that is a model for the rest of the state, and the rest of the state should pay more attention
thank
to what Hobbs is doing.
Thank you for noting that. Absolutely.
They've written their own plan.
That's right.
I was happy to see West Mesa High School make that list. Yeah. I think that's great. I think the really puzzling thing for me is that West Mesa's principal, under which they made that progress, was moved in this APS rearrangement scheme.
That's right.
And that's been one of the, I think, problems with people at West Mesa. They're puzzled as to why that move was made.
That's right. 10 seconds.
You know, I think it's actually kind of good for our educational self-esteem and that we maybe need a little bit of that. I don't think we can say, like, and therefore these 3 schools are fixed forever. But I mean, I think it is helpful in that it focuses us on education in a positive way.
Well done.
Can keep thinking about it.
Governor Richardson is once again considering giving Billy the Kid the pardon that Governor Lew Wallace promised him over a century ago. Billy's fans like the idea, but historians are leery about the historical accuracy. Is this merely a publicity stunt for an outgoing governor, or does this issue, Laura, have some resonance for New Mexicans?
I think every governor 6 months out is going to be looking for something to hang their hat on. I think this one has some legs because there are a fair amount of fans, and as an economic development tool to try to bring people to the state, I support continuing to discuss this issue.
There you go. The historical accuracy is an interesting point.
Here's what I want to know.
Yeah.
How soon after Billy is pardoned will he get out of jail?
Right.
Because I know that he's waiting.
Right.
And his family is concerned. You know what? I have a hard time thinking that this is like an awesome thing. We have so much to worry about and work on. And Billy is not going anywhere.
Right.
he can wait.
I think the ACLU may step into this one, you never know. Stephanie, what do you
think? Well, I'm just puzzled as to why the historical accuracy is even being questioned. We've all seen Young Guns 2. I mean, we know what really happened. So I just don't understand why we're going to put resources. No, all things kidding. No, I think it's an interesting topic. I would be interested to see the results of it, you know, intense forensic investigation. Yeah. But
opposition, there is some out there.
Well, now that Governor Richardson has balanced the budget and fixed the schools, he needs something else to do. So I hope he turns his considerable energies to this. No, there's a lot of debate on both sides of this. The sad thing about it is I've heard local sheriff's departments in Lincoln County and state government combined have spent $100,000 to $200,000 on this. Oh, that's boy. Not right.
Yeah, I hear that. Activists are asking Senator Udall to co-sponsor the DREAM Act, which would allow undocumented immigrant students who have lived in the U.S. since at least the age of 15 a path to citizenship, provided they complete college or serve time in the military. Opponents call this a handout to illegal immigrants. But supporters, Laura, call it a reward for people who are willing to take the proper steps to come into their adopted nation. And we had that, let me add this to it, we had that situation, as we all saw in Harvard, with that kid that grew up in San Antonio, you know, was trying to get back in the plane, and that's all well and good, and that's great. And he's a model citizen, but there's a lot of not model citizens out there that perhaps might feel a little left out of the loop here. What do you think?
Well, I think this one is worth looking at. I hope that Senator Udall does consider supporting it. Mm-hmm. I think it's one of those, this for me, somebody who's been in this country at least since the age of 15 and has worked hard enough to get through college or 2 years of the military, I think they should have an opportunity to become a citizen. I don't understand why prohibiting productive citizens would be a problem.
Mm-hmm. Jim?
Let's not hang on to the not model citizens. Let's be selfish and act in our self-interest and grab these bright, young, hardworking people and make them part of our workforce, legally.
Yeah, Stephanie? I agree. And the 2000 census showed that actually half of all of our graduating engineers and scientists are immigrants. And I think that we need to encourage this. I think this legislation does that.
Excellent. Sophie?
I can't disagree with anything anybody has said. I think it's a good... I also think it's a good step forward when we talk about how we need immigration reform. Mm-hmm. This seems like a big slam dunk to me.
Sure, let's see what Mr. Udall does. Now, local youths made news nationwide by breaking into the Rio Grande Zoo, taking photos of themselves mingling. It's a good word. With the animals. How does one mingle with a giraffe? And then posting these photos on Facebook. This isn't the first time people have posted their misadventures on social networking sites. Sophie, got to start with you. How could they possibly think they could have gotten away with this?
I don't know that they thought they were going to get away with it. I mean, not able to read their minds. But my suspicion is that they were like, I hope as many people as possible see this. Mm-hmm. We are now sort of living in this strange culture in the U.S. where notoriety is more important than safety or reason or, you know, non-idiocy. Mm-hmm. I think that this was their path to fame and potentially.
And so
fortune.
Many of these stories, you guys, we all have seen them where people do this and the outcome, Stephanie, is not good.
No.
Because these are wild animals.
No, it's not.
Yeah,
I think these individuals are extremely lucky, extremely fortunate that they didn't get, as one article said, their heads kicked in by a giraffe.
Mm-hmm. Right?
I mean, this is disturbing.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Well, now I hope that their heads get kicked in by the authorities since they were stupid
exactly.
enough to put their pictures out there showing them trespassing and breaking the law. Yep. And I don't think they went to the high schools that have done so well on that Newsweek survey.
Good point.
I think we see a decline of common sense in our youth and in our society in general. I would agree with what Sophie said. I mean, we're reaching a point where instantaneous notoriety is more important than having a clean record, mm-hmm. and that is valued more in the long run mm-hmm. than ensuring that you don't have to deal with the criminal justice system, and I think mm-hmm. that's really sad.
That fellow that kissed the giraffe, you know, it's like...
He could have gotten his face ripped
absolutely.
Off. Those teeth are as
absolutely.
Big as his nose.
Craziest thing in the world.
The sad thing is that they would have turned around and sued the zoo.
That's right, the zoo.
Yeah.
Right.
Of course. We'll see you Friday night at 7 on KNME.